How does Bitcoin mining work? Hi everyone, I'm Leo Notenboom for askleo.com, where, yes, I own a tiny little bit of Bitcoin, mostly as an experiment from years ago. One of the things we keep hearing in the news, of course, is this concept of Bitcoin mining. And it's an odd concept to consider when, in fact, Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency, which means it doesn't exist in any form other than ones and zeros on some computer somewhere. What does it mean to mine something that doesn't physically exist? To understand that and why it actually matters, without going into the weeds on the incredibly complex details that actually are Bitcoin itself, I'm going to try and come up with a metaphor that will hopefully make this a little bit more understandable. The caveat, of course, is that this is in no way intended to be a primer on Bitcoin itself or any of the details of exactly how Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies work. But mining at a very high level, at like a 50,000 foot level, is actually not that difficult a concept. So what I want you to envision is a game. The game we're going to play is simply that I want you to pick a number between 1 and a billion. If you guess the number correctly, I will give you $1. That's the game. Seriously, that's what Bitcoin mining is really all about. It really is that simple. Of course, it's an oversimplified analogy, but at the conceptual level, that's exactly what Bitcoin mining is all about. Now, there are a couple of additional characteristics to this game. One is you can guess as many times as you like. Also, you're not the only person guessing. The first person to guess correctly is the person that gets the dollar. Now it's become a competition. The more quickly you can throw out guesses, the more likely it is you'll win the dollar. Finally, as soon as someone guesses it correctly, whoever that may be, we start the game over. I pick a new number between 1 and a billion, and everybody starts guessing again. So, what happens if a billion people guess, right? Chances are that's not going to happen. But what if we have a lot of people guessing and the right number comes up very, very quickly? Well, I don't want to give my dollars away that quickly. I throttle the competition. The way I do that is if I find that people are getting the right answer too quickly, I change the game ever so slightly. Rather than guessing between 1 and a billion, I change it to say, okay, we're guessing between 1 and 10 billion right now. I just made the game 10 times harder. If that's still happening too quickly, I'll say, okay, the rule is now between 1 and 100 billion. I've now made it 10 times more difficult to win again. If it's still happening too quickly, I'll say, fine, the number now has to be somewhere between 1 and a trillion. I've made it 10 times harder than the previous iteration and 1,000 times harder than what we started with. You get the idea. I can throttle how quickly I give away my dollars by choosing how difficult to make the game. Now, that is, again, the game that Bitcoin is playing when it comes to mining. That's the concept behind Bitcoin mining. A bunch of people are trying to guess a number in order to get a reward. Now, the reward, as you might already guess, is in fact Bitcoin. In fact, at this writing, it is 6 1/4 Bitcoin, which at this writing actually is something like $325,000. So there's a lot of motivation for people to get the number correct. That means A lot of people, and I do mean a lot of people, are throwing a lot of hardware, and I do mean a lot of hardware, very high-end hardware that is capable of calculating and making guesses very, very quickly at the problem. In fact, they're throwing so much hardware at making these guesses that they use a lot of electricity. That's why you keep hearing these stories about how Bitcoin is somehow responsible for this massive amount of energy use. What's really responsible are all of these Bitcoin miners out there using as much hardware as they can get their hands on to guess as quickly as they possibly can and get the right number and get those 6.25 Bitcoin. The Bitcoin algorithm does in fact throttle. They actually try to have a winner roughly every 10 minutes. So what that means is that there are 10 minutes worth of guesses being thrown out all the time. Somebody wins and they start over. If people start winning too frequently, in other words, significantly faster than 10 minutes on average, they make the game harder. They increase the range of possible answers so that it becomes that much more difficult for people to guess the correct number. Now, of course, they're not just guessing between 0 and a trillion or 0 and a quadrillion or something like that. What they're doing is actually having to calculate a number. That calculation, a cryptographic hash, has to have a certain characteristic in order for it to win the competition. Cryptographic hashes are computationally intensive, which means that they require a lot of math. That's why high-end hardware is used to try and calculate that hash as quickly as is possible, to be able to throw out as many guesses as they possibly can in the allotted time. High-end hardware is, in fact, one of the solutions. The other is to throw as much hardware at it as possible. So, for example, maybe you have one incredibly fast machine that's throwing out guesses as quickly as it is possible to guess. An alternative is instead to have maybe thousands of not quite as high-end machines all making guesses, all being assigned different ranges perhaps to guess in, but basically spreading the load of all that guesswork across multiple machines. Taken to its extreme, that's why some malware will actually try and install Bitcoin mining software on your PC. Yep, your PC is probably pretty low end compared to some of these other machines I've been talking about. But if they get enough of them, if they get their malware installed on maybe millions of machines, each of those machines contributes just a little bit to the hacker potentially being able to win the calculation. That is what Bitcoin mining is all about. Using computers to run calculations in order to get an answer with a correct characteristic. All of that calculation takes time. All of that calculation takes resources. And the resource that is most commonly discussed in the press is the electricity that it all uses. Hopefully, at a high level, that helps you understand just a little bit of what Bitcoin is all about, or at least what Bitcoin mining is all about. For the article, which does go into this in a little bit more depth, on which this video is based, for updates, for comments, for related links, visit askleo.com/47790. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.